I'm going to be talking about BTTC-0901, a phase 1-2 trial of Everolimus and Sorafenib for patients with recurrent malignant gliomas.
BTTC-09-01 study.
This is a phase 1-2 trial using two drugs called Everolimus and Sorafenib in combination to treat patients with recurrent glioblastoma or recurrent anaplastic gliomas. The basis for the study is to determine, one, if the combination is safe, which is a phase 1 which has now been completed, and the second phase, the phase 2, is using the combination to see if we can improve outcomes for patients who have recurrent glioblastoma who have either failed bevacizumab or have not been treated with bevacizumab, as well as a group of grade 3 patients who have never been treated with bevacizumab before.
Eligibility criteria.
As part of the eligibility criteria for the study, patients will have to have a recurrent malignant glioma. These can either be a grade 3 tumor or a grade 4 tumor, often called anaplastic astrocytomas or glioblastomas. Other parts of the major eligibility criteria are that these patients will have to have recurrent tumors, so they are not newly diagnosed. They will have to have normal laboratory parameters to make sure their kidney, their liver, their blood counts are all under normal limits. They can also not have prior history of hepatitis or HIV or any intrinsic lung disease, kidney disease, or cardiac dysfunction, which could be problematic for patients taking these medications. The medications are provided on the trial. All patients will be given a study calendar to use prior to taking the drugs at home, as both of them are administered as oral pills for the patients to take. They do not require coming to the hospital. The drugs are provided by the clinical trial, and most aspects of the clinical trial will be billed to the patient's insurance company. However, if there are specific study requirements related to research, those will be covered by the clinical trial.
Potential risk and benefits.
As with all chemotherapeutic agents, there's a number of side effects that patients can endure while they're on the study. Most of the side effects we've learned about come from other indications where these drugs have been used, but we will be monitoring for safety while patients are on this study. There are certain risks, and some of them may be unique for patients with brain tumors, although most of the time we do not see any unique toxicities in this patient population. While we don't know if the medications will help treat your tumor, that is the real hope of the study, that we can control your disease for a period of time, if not potentially indefinitely. Patients will remain on study for as long as they're tolerating the medication. That means not having any adverse side effects, which cannot be controlled with either lowering the dose, holding the dose, or by stopping the medication for a short period of time, as long as they want to be on the clinical trial, and as long as we see that the drug is benefiting them and their tumor has not started to recur.
Enrollment.
The trial will enroll approximately 30 patients in each arm for the phase 2 study. The phase 1 study was a smaller number of patients, which is now completed. For more information about the trial, we would like you to go to the BTTC website to learn more about it, to see if it's something that you're interested in or if it fits your specific disease criteria.
Everolimus and Sorafenib rationale.
I encourage you to watch my other video on how the mechanism of action of these two drugs work and the rationale for combining them in an attempt to try to treat your tumor.
For more information, visit ccr.cancer.gov/neuro-oncology-branch/BTTC. Protocol number 16-C-0011.
U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, National Institutes of Health, National Cancer Institute, cancer.gov, 1-800-4-CANCER. Produced December 2017.